Thank you. Good afternoon. Welcome to Trinity United Church. My name is Gordon McLean, and assisting me in our service today, our service of worship, is our organist, Dr. Peter McDonald, and our soloist, Lori Labors. And we're here today on this beautiful day for the special occasion to mark the marriage of Deborah Ann Marsh and Anthony Edgar McKay, and to ask God to bless them. As it says in Scripture, unless the Lord builds the house, those who build it labor in vain. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make straight your paths. Anthony Edgar McKay and Deborah Ann Marsh, you signify your desire to enter into the holy state of marriage, and no one is shown any just cause where you may not. If either of you in only modern impediment why you should not be married, I charge you before God, the searcher of all hearts, to declare it. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, in whom we live and move and have our being, grant unto us purity of heart and strength of purpose, so that no selfish passion may hinder us from knowing your will, and no weakness from doing it. That in your light we may see light, and in your service find perfect freedom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The guests of the family, please be seated. Share this reading with you this afternoon from 1 Corinthians. It's Paul's writing about love. And Paul says, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends.
Thank you.
Holy Scripture. In John it says, "As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you." And in the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus said, "Have you not read that he who made them from the beginning made them male and female, and said, 'For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one.' So they are no longer two, but one. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder." Today we are gathered for this special occasion here in Trinity United to wish Tony and Debbie God's blessing and God's peace. By our presence here, we accept responsibility for supporting them in this new relationship that they are about to enter. There might be some important things on this day. When people get married, they worry about the weather. Well, God is cooperating with weather. And some other things they might worry about. They might be a little anxious about the way things are going to happen and unfold. But God has blessed us with being here. And the most significant and important thing is the love that these two people find in each other. So by our presence here, we accept responsibility for supporting them in this new relationship. We are called to rejoice today in their happiness, to be patient when they make mistakes, to remember them always in times of trouble, and to support them always in our prayers. God established marriage that men and women might have companionship, that natural affections and instincts might be filled in mutual love, that our society might rest on a strong foundation, that of the home, and that any children may be blessed with love and blessing within their home through Christ our Lord. The Apostle Paul compared married love to that of Christ of his church, in which he declared a life of self-giving love. And that's what he asked for marriage to be, a life of self-giving love. So Tony and Debbie, your marriage joins you today for life in a relationship so intimate, the profound affects your whole being. It offers you the promise of a love that is true and a love that is mature. And such a love requires that you commit your lives to one another freely and without reserve. You do this for the sake of a wider and deeper and a richer life together. I ask you to become one in mind and in heart, as well as one in body. And trust in the living Christ, and he will guide and support you on your way. I invite you to join with me in prayer as we pray for this young man and young woman as they begin to make their marriage vows. Let us pray. Almighty God, who from the beginning hast made man and woman for each other, let your Holy Spirit rest upon these your servants, as in your name they pledge themselves to one another in vows of love and faithfulness. Let your love be upon them, as their hope is in you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. For the guests and the family, please stand. Tony, will you have this woman to be your wife? If so, answer, I will. Debbie, will you have this man to be your husband? If so, answer, I will. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Jesus said, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. In this he meant that love and life is eternal through him, and these rings today are the symbol of the marriage and the symbol of the love that these two people find in each other. And we know that God blesses them through the symbolic union of this ring. Debbie, I give you this ring that you may wear it as a symbol of the vows we have made this day. Lord bless and sustain you. The Lord pour the riches of his grace upon you, that you may please him in body and spirit, and grow together in love all the days of your life. Amen. The guests of the family, please be seated. Let us join our hearts and minds together in the fellowship of prayer. Let us pray. O God, you are the Lord of life and love eternal, author of all good and giver of all joy. We thank you for the gift of marriage. We bless you for the joy which these your servants have found in each other, and for the covenant which they have made before you. Gracious Father, whose love is everlasting, grant that Debbie and Tony may dwell together in unity and love all the days of their life. Give them health, prosperity, and peace. Strengthen them to obey and serve you, that they may walk in the steps of Jesus Christ, your Son. And when the joys and sorrows and all the good and evil of this passing world are ended, let them inherit your promises and share in your eternal glory. O God, our Heavenly Father, look in favor upon all our homes. Defend it against evil from within and without, and supply their needs according to the riches of your grace. And bless all those who have gathered here today for this special occasion. We thank you especially for the gift of music, and the gift of love expressed in the gift of music. And may you bless all those who have come from some distance to be here, and all those who are journeying on their way on this day. So for ourselves we pray, O Lord, that directed by your Spirit, we may look each to the good of others in word and deed, and grow in grace as we advance in years, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who gave this gift of prayer to his beloved. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
Just have one announcement before I present the new cup to you. Please wait till you're over in Wood Islands before you throw them in the cake. Ladies and gentlemen, guests and family, it is a great pleasure at this time to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Tony McKay.
You're welcome to come to your session for a
I'm not sure.
McGuire.
I wish I could remember.
I've
got folks around at home
if
and all
had
kinds
the tea,
of stuff
I
there. And it's great. I got all this stuff ready and nobody eats. They came and said they were late for breakfast and they didn't want to eat. So it's awesome.
Yes, which one do you try on?
Hey! Hi! 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 H
Thank you. was all
$80 for the Halloween candy and stuff like that.
Well, I'll tell you something. One time I was up in the... when I was living in Ontario, I was in the store one day shopping. And this girl was walking behind me, and I went, she was behind me. I thought, well, I'm not stealing anything. I just got in the car and moved the paper. So I left her up to the counter. She was right behind me. And I said, what are you doing? She said, I'm not following you. I have to go there. She's got a little coat on off and stuff. I was just waiting for the police to arrive at the door. When he picked it off, he opened the coat and I'm going to go to stuff she had.
I'm shocked
when
I see that.
I
got television here.
I'll tell you. What's she doing there? Boiling your fine butter in two dishes.
Yeah, that's pretty good, isn't it?
Well, she's trying to build one in the middle.
That's prosperity, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's great to be getting the pensions.
Oh, you don't get it yet.
Yes, we get the pensions. Hey, George.
You do not wait.
That's not me. You, girl.
I know she gets it.
Sure, she does.
Well, I don't know what to do with it.
Yeah.
Mary Reynolds says she paid $2,000 in income tax last year.
Mary Reynolds?
Yeah.
I wonder why. Yeah, he's dead.
Red Fox gone too.
Yeah,
his skeleton's still living.
Yeah,
I like him. Have you seen him now?
Don't see him looking
all
right.
We haven't seen
him.
He must be a very old man.
Yeah.
His face is smooth. He said he's lifted.
Yeah. He did it lifted, yeah.
His face lifted.
Yeah.
So you can't see your fingers.
Oh, and Mrs. Fraser had an operation on her nose.
Did she? How come she said, what did I say to her one day? She said that.
I don't know. She said she was playing ball so when she was young or something. She got hit with a ball on her nose. And then, oh, I don't know what it was, but there was something. She had to have a little cast on it or something.
Yes, sir, right? Thanks for tea, Duke.
Oh, poor little doggy.
What are you doing, hurting him?
No. Oh, poor little fellow, where is he?
This was my grandmother's house. Now we're looking up at McMaster's house.
I think we go, I don't know, we can go through that way and go back, not into school enough.
This is nice.
Or maybe just a glass. We're getting a picture up there, I think.
This is a view of Emery's Island. This house here is Taurus. The Claris.
Is it saying recording?
Yeah.
Right, push the button again. And you get a TV picture?
Yeah.
Is it filling the screen? Is it filling the viewer, or is it?
Tanika Campbell had a little girl.
Who?
Tanika Campbell.
Who was she?
She worked at the Royal Bank there. She was a Thai girl. She was due.
Oh, that one with the blonde hair.
The Epiquette is preparing to make her last voyage with people upon her, at least passengers of sort. This is the sail of a lifetime, I believe they call it. Ironically, the people that are taking this sail, they had to pay considerable to go on, I guess it goes to charity. But most of these people are people that were very much in favor of the bridge. Ironically, they're the ones that get a chance to sail in her last. Last night, sometime after midnight, the Epiquette left the Borden dock for the last time. She was taken up by Captain Roy Coffin, who was incidentally the first captain on her when she first came here.
I can't figure that out. Thank you.